Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. In alhamdulillah, nahmadu ta'ala, wa nasta'inu, wa nasta'gfiru, wa nasta'hdi. Min yahdi Allah, fala mudillalah, wa man yudlil, fala hadiyalah. Wa nashadu an la ilaha illallah, al-qa'il fi kitabi al-kareem. Wa inna hadha sirati mustaqimin fa'tabi'u wa la ta'tabi'u subul fatafarraq bikum an sabilihi dhalikum wasaakum bihi la'allakum tattaqun wa nashhadu anna Muhammadan 'abduhu wa rasuluhu alladhi amarna bitamassak bil 'urwati wuthqa wa hadharna min al ahwa wal bid'ah. فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم في حديث عرباد بن سارية لقد تركتم على مثل بيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ بعدي عنها إلا هالك. We praise and thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we bear witness that He's the only one worthy of worship. We seek His help and assistance. We seek His guidance. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides, there is no one who can lead him astray. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala leaves to go astray, there is no guidance for him. And we bear witness that there is no God worthy of worship except Allah, who said in the Quran, verily this is my path, my straight path, so then follow it, and do not follow the various paths and divide on the straight path, and that is my guidance for you in order that you will fear me. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes clear that He has a straight path, and He subhanahu wa ta'ala laid that straight path and made it clear for us. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam traversed that path, and his sunnah is a part of that path, alayhi salatu wasalam. And we bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is the last slave or last messenger and slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sallallahu alayhi wasallam, who ordered us sallallahu alayhi wasallam to hold on to that straight path, to the rope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to the urwatul wuthqa. And he warned us against going astray and against following Ahla Bid'ah, the people of desires and the people of innovation in the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith of Irbad ibn Sariya radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that I've left you upon something that is very clear. The night, its night is like its day, and no one deviates from it except that they are destroyed. And that's the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, meaning that if you deviate from the sunnah of Nabi and Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then you're heading to the path of destruction. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam also said in another hadith of Irbad bin Sariya radiallahu ta'ala anhu, where he said sallallahu alaihi wasallam qala iyyakum wa muhtathat al-umur fa inna kulla bid'atin dalala. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, beware of newly invented matters, for every newly invented matter is a going astray, and every bid'ah, every innovation is deviation. It's misguidance. This is the speech of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, that when we say we follow the salaf of this ummah, when we say we are sunni, when we say we tamassak bi sunnah, and all of these other terms, and we're from ahla hadith, we're ahla athar, we're salafi, whatever the term may be that refers to ahla sunnah, that requires from us that action. It requires for us to follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, even in our da'wah, even in the way we call others to Islam. That means that's our path, that's our minhaj, that's our methodology, that we can't compromise that. We don't see that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam compromised even one thing. When you can imagine, when the Quraysh, his tribe, a tribe that had honor and esteem amongst the other Arabs, but they were mushriks, and they fought the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they wanted him to compromise his own family members, alayhi salatu wasalam, but he held steadfast. He kept on the sabil Allah. He kept on the sirat al-mustaqim. He kept calling to tawheed and he didn't compromise it. Even though he could have did things to entertain the Quraysh, and he could have accepted compromise and worshiped their gods one day and worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala another day. Or he could have accepted marriage proposals and did whatever it takes to compromise and make it easier for the Quraysh to digest, but not the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He didn't do that. And so that's why in the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we see a pristine example for us that we shouldn't compromise our da'wah, that we should make our da'wah mabniyatun ala ikhlas lillah wa ala mutaba' nabiyyana Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that it should be on sincerity to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it should be upon following the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So that's what we want to highlight, and we want to remind ourselves and remind our brothers and sisters who are involved in da'wah that they should call to kitabillah, and they should ask themselves anytime they're doing some da'wah. Because this is how the Salaf were. They feared Allah and they feared falling into shirk and they feared showing off. Then they feared these things. So ask every time you're doing some sort of da'wah, ask, are you doing it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or the sake of the people? Are you compromising those principles and those qawaid and that usul and that foundation that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam laid for us? Or are you following, are you tamassuk bi sunnah to the best of your ability? And even if you call yourself Salafi, and even if you call yourself Sunni, and even if you call yourself from Ahla Athar or Ahla Hadith, the ulama, they say, Al-Ibra bi haqaiq, laysa bi musammiyat. That the Ibra, the proof of something, is not in what it's called, but it's in what it is. So even if someone says they're from Ahla Sunnah, it's their actions and their aqidah and their minhaj and their methodology in giving da'wah and their manners and all of these things that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam exhibited and illustrated for us. That's how we make our judgment. That's our scale. So it isn't that we are beating up on our brothers and sisters who are doing good. Maybe they're doing a janib of good. They're calling people to the sunnah or they're calling people to khair. But they've mixed it with falsehood. They've mixed it with some other things or where they compromise the principles in order to get more numbers. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't ask for more numbers. During the lifetime of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there wasn't millions of Muslims. Now we have a billion and a half Muslims on this planet. But can we say that billion and a half is on the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? How many of those people have bid'ah, mukaffara, that takes them out of the fold of Islam? How many of those people are on so many different groups and manahij that they're just on the border of Islam? How many people don't even pray? How many people commit every kind of sin you can imagine? And we have a lot of numbers. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, he said that we would be like the foam of the sea. As he said in the authentic narration, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that when they asked, Ya Rasulullah, will we be few in numbers? He said, La, but you'll be like the foam of the sea. You know, and the foam, you know, it bubbles up on the sea and then it just washes away. So we'll be large in numbers as we are today, but we're weak. We're weak in our practice. We're weak in our ilm and our understanding. We're weak in our da'wah and how we call people to Islam and how we call our other brothers, Muslims and sisters in Islam to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We're weak in this. And so we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil and bless us to come back to Kitabillah with sunnah to Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And anything I said that was correct was from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anything I said that was incorrect was from myself and the shaitan. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Thank you.